You don't know my story. At least, I can tell you three experiences of ladies that were in a cult, a marine cult. They sent them from there. Say, that pastor is causing us problems. Go and fall, make him fall. You can't make a man fall that has found the love of God. The love will constrain him. It's a proof that you have something with God. Your intimacy is currency. When God can constrain you, God can stop you. But if you go all the way, it means you had nothing with God. You had nothing with him. Those vows you make by the altar, oh man, those vows you make by the altar on your wedding day, I assure you, you don't have the ability to keep it. And if God wants to help you to keep it, what he does is that he causes his love to cause. Oh man, God will not stop creating beautiful ladies just because of you. A lot of you will see God, but the love of Christ, what does it do? And you begin to see how God regulates your life just because of that love edge. You don't want to break his heart. It means you're on the path. Your journey of intimacy has begun. If God can constrain, I'm going to stop here today. The Bible says, let your affections be set on things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Your relationship with God must be affectionate. That's a proof that you have arrived the tabernacle. You're operating from the secret place. Love of God. It constrains you. I'm going to pray in a moment. Okay, let's use this night for practical. So if you have come to a point where God can constrain you, it means that you have started touching the depths of God. You have started feeling what is in the bowels of God. And that is great power. Whereas men will take off in different directions like tornadoes. And after 12 years, they will know they were wrong. A man that stays and can connect with the powers of Christ, such a man will be relevant throughout his life because he is operated by the spirit of prophecy. Alright, let me take you, let's go to the practical session. First of all, if you want to draw him from inside to come out, first of all, set your heart as though nothing in this world is important, only God. It's something you can do, even now. You set your heart as what? As though nothing is important. The only thing that is important is what? Is God. And you set your heart like that. When you set your heart like that, the next thing you do is to stir your spirit. And the best way to do it is to speak in tongues. See, but don't speak in tongues in such a way that the tongues will distract you. Speak in tongues in such a way that you are using the tongues to gain ascendancy. As a locomotive train that is moving. And set your heart. Only him. Only him. Only him. If you can do that, it takes a lot of discipline because you need to put your mind, set your affection, put your mind on him. If your mind leaves him, catch your mind and say, come on, go back. And stay there. Can you do that? All right, let's try. Forget about your neighbor. You came with your sister. Forget about her. And then you, as you set your heart, begin to speak in tongues. Begin to speak in tongues and mobilize mobilize your heart. Mobilize your heart. He will come out from inside. Mobilize your heart. Mobilize your heart. Sheiko presco falami siko skepro umpele. Mansko fresco petama scuse zaiko balahaita kumpele. It is for you only that I live, that I move, that I have my being. It is only when I make contact with you that my life begins to roll. Oh God, do not hide your face, do not hide your heart. Mesko previ lasko patwa la manze isko predo ko pre askita palatala. Sheklo proke balatuza mahaito ko pre. I surrender. Sometimes when you begin to go like that, it begins to show you things you need to surrender. You need to let go this. You need to let go that. You need to allow that relationship go. You need to allow this thing go. Leave that crisis. Leave that land. Leave that property. Leave that inheritance. Just stay with me. Just stay. He begins to enlighten the eyes of your understanding, and then many visions will begin to come on your face. You can see things. You can know things supernaturally. The unction of the Holy One is suddenly activated, and your ability to know things that you were not taught begins to find expression. A river of life begins to flow. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. If you do that, it will take 5 to 7 minutes for your spirit to adjust properly, and then you begin to see visions. Spiritual visions are not as clear as physical visions. Flashes. They're not as clear. Now, I've seen one already. That's why I stopped you. They're not as clear as physical visions. So if you are too fleshly, you will miss the sign that is spiritual. Because spiritual signs are very faint. Only the trained will know them. And I beheld a star fall from heaven. And when I saw it, it fell and stood on the ear of somebody. Somebody's ear. And I was saying, what is this? Then he began to...